is pretty typical when you see these puffy clouds, and that was the case. There were several of them lined right up. They're bumpy on the top here, but very flat on the bottom. This has a specific name right here, and we could tell during the day, in the morning, before these clouds even form, exactly how high, pretty much exactly how high they're going to form. That is what's called the lifting condensation level.
It's Jay Dreamers. I'm going to do a quick video talking about the clouds once again. I know my last video kind of was hard to hear because of the wind, but I want you to look at the clouds. Consider the clouds when you consider the flat earth. Look at these clouds. Now, first of all, I pointed out that the clouds are parallel to the earth on the bottom. In other words, the clouds are flat on the bottom, and on the top, they're rounded. They're marshmallowy on top. Always flat on the bottom and marshmallowy on the top. Now, something else I noticed is that when you look at the silver lining, I'm directly under the silver lining of these clouds. Okay, so I see a lot of silver lining. But then the further away you get, the smaller the silver lining becomes. And that's because the clouds are not tilting away from me as they follow the curvature of the earth. Instead, the clouds are remaining parallel on a flat earth, and thus the silver lining on the cloud gets thinner and smaller the further away they are. You see that? You can also kind of see there's a sun spot right above me because that sun is nearby. It's not far away. Anyways, consider the clouds, guys. Do some videos, check it out. Look at these clouds, look at the silver lining as it gets smaller and smaller. You see how the clouds stack as they get further and further away? Can you see the vanishing point? Can you see the perspective in the shot? Look at that. The clouds on the bottom are flat and parallel with the horizon, with the earth. That is also flat, and they stay that way across the entire plane of the earth.
Don't know if you noticed the clouds this evening. Really quite interesting. And so every night here on Fox 9 News at 9, we take a closer look at the weather, try to learn something. So we asked Scott Dorval, or at least I did, to kind of explain some of this to us. Really, the clouds were just gorgeous in the sunlight, and but I don't really understand how it all works.
Yeah, did you notice the clouds? It was some of them had flat bottoms, some of them had flat tops as well. We'll talk about why that occurs. Usually you'll see the flat bottoms. This is a picture I took this evening. I was driving down a Road from Napa heading towards Meridian, and you'll see here, notice the cloud bottoms are flat. This is pretty typical when you see these puffy clouds, and that was the case. There were several of them lined right up. They're bumpy on the top here, but very flat on the bottom. This has a specific name right here, and we could tell during the day, in the morning, before these clouds even form, exactly how high, pretty much exactly how high they're going to form. That is what's called the lifting condensation level. This was the scenario in the atmosphere today. It was 47 degrees at about 7 o'clock tonight. It was 5 degrees at the base of that cloud right here. So what happens during the day is the sun is warming. The sun does not warm the air directly. It's minuscule how it warms the air directly. It will warm the ground, solid objects like us. That's what we feel the warming, or the ground. The ground will then radiate heat and energy upwards. As that air rises, it cools. And so at 2,858 feet at the airport, up to a base level of the cloud at 10,000 feet, that's where the cloud then condenses and forms the cloud, and it's a direct line. line. This is the lifting condensation level, and generally you'll have puffy clouds above it. Michelle, you saw some flat clouds at the top. Those are little thunderstorms trying to form, reaching the top layer of the atmosphere where it's warmer aloft always, and so the clouds will then go up and then just lose their buoyancy and just flatten right out aloft. So interesting, definitely interesting look at the cloud cover today and the bases of those clouds. If the air is dry, it raises, it goes all the way up to 5,000 feet. That air has to rise really far to get that moisture to condense. When you have humid air in the wintertime, the cloud bases are lower, and the cloud bases will be around 3,000 feet. Come summertime, when we get some of those thunderstorms, Michelle, we're talking cloud bases that are 10, 15,000 feet high, thunderstorm bases, and that's why it's so far for that rain to fall, it doesn't quite make it to the ground, and so we have a dry lightning that occurs and a lot of gusty winds. If you've got interesting questions or photos, weather at fox9now.com. Michelle?
I can tell you this, Scott, I would have done a lot better in science had you been teaching me.
Well,
true.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, some big news.